Princess, round two. You want some more pancakes?
So you think you have enough there, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
No syrup, or you got enough?
Looks like she has a second and third helping of it on her chin.
It's because it's so good.
It is good. She's just happy you're home. You're happy daddy's home, huh?
So am I. I don't think I could have stayed in the hotel after last night.
You know, just don't beat yourself up anymore about Jake. There's no way you could have saved him.
I think intellectually I know that. When I saw the scans, I knew that, but you know me, I wanted to save him. I don't even want to think what Elizabeth and Lucky are going through right now.
You know, it just makes me realize all over again how lucky we are to have our little girl, our messy little girl. And I'm pretty grateful that you're home, too.
I want you to know that I'm going to do everything I can to make us stronger. Make sure we stay together. I hope that's what you want.
I'm happy that you're home. I'd like you to stay. There you go. Is that what you want?
Yes. More than you know.
You know, there are some things in our marriage that it won't be fixed overnight.
I know. I know that. Well, like I just said, I'm gonna do whatever it takes.
So am I.
Good. Well, hopefully it'll be a little easier once Lisa Niles is out of our lives.
I want more syrup.
Okay, sweetheart. Yesterday, after we heard about Jake, I went and I put the needle in my locker and I didn't even give Lisa a second thought.
I don't blame you, but we need to get that needle to Steve. We gotta end this insanity once and for all. I just keep going over my head, thinking of what I could have done differently in the procedure. I looked at the reports of the surgery, Patrick. I saw the scans. Jake was way too injured for anyone to save.
Yeah. Steve. I'm so sorry.
Thanks for everything you tried to do. And I know I still need to deal with this whole Lisa issue.
No. That can wait. Just focus on Elizabeth. Let her know that we're here. You know, if she needs anything.
I'll tell her. Dr. Hendrick,
call 3827.
What's wrong with you? Last time I left you, you were all giggling with Emma with syrup all over your face.
Lisa broke into my locker and stole the syringe.
You gotta be kidding me. You telling me she used the distraction of a dying child to cover her own ass?
Come on, that surprises you?
It's not surprising. But I guess we gotta go back to perspective. It's no use wasting any time on Lisa, especially after losing Jake.
That's true. We need to focus on this morning, having pancakes with our little girl, and think about our future and the lesson that we learned together, and appreciate everything we've been given.
Excuse me, guys. You got time for a few questions about Jake Weber?
Yeah, I can tell you. I was the surgeon. I can tell you when he died and how it happened, if you'd like.
I'm working on the accident itself. We have traffic footage from an intersection near the spot where Jake was killed. We think it happened between 8 and 8:05, and one of the vehicles that passed through at that time was yours, Dr. Scorpio. Do you remember anything from driving last night, anything out of the ordinary?
No. I mean, I was driving on Lexington. I was trying to get back to GH as fast as I could, and Lisa was chasing me, and I remember seeing her brights in my rear view, and, well, I guess I was a little distracted because I was paying attention to the crazy person behind me, not the road in front of me.
But you didn't do this.
What if I did? What if I'm the one that hit Jake?
Okay, forensics is gonna need to take a look at your vehicle.
Well, make sure you check Lisa's car, too.
Well, if she did, I still played a part in it.
Okay, I'm gonna check in with my people, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.
Thank you.
How do I face Elizabeth?
Robin, you didn't do this.
What if I did? What if I did? What if I hit him? And then why wasn't I just paying more attention to the road?
Because you were being chased by a crazy woman. You know, I told Johnny that somebody was gonna die if he kept up this stupid game. I just didn't think it was gonna be a 4-year-old kid. That was Marucci. He's gonna cover for you.
Good. It wouldn't be any good to my patients today. I don't want anyone suffering because
Robin,
of me.
Stop. Please, you didn't do this.
I've been to Elizabeth's house 100 times. I mean, I don't even remember going past her driveway.
You're innocent.
Maybe you just want me to be. But the truth is, I know it could have been me. It's Dante. Hello? Thank you.
What?
My car's been cleared. There's no DNA evidence or sign of a collision.
Thank God.
It still feels so awful.
Did you say anything about Lisa?
No.
All right, well, you better hurry up. I'm sure she's already got it in Johnny's garage getting fixed and cleaned up.
We don't know it was Lisa.
She chased you to the yard last night, didn't she?
Yeah, I took a shortcut and I lost her after that.
Well, as much as I believed you were innocent, I believe just as much as she's guilty.
Robin Scorpio.